Hello friends, this is Team Super Simplified and today we are going to discuss the Satluj-Yamuna link canal controversy. So this is a very hot topic now ongoing in the news and there's a lot of hue and cry around this. So aapne iske bare mein thoda bahut padha bhi hoga, we will try to get into the detail of that. So before starting the controversy part of it, we will look at the project first of all, the technicalities of the project, why it is needed, what it is trying to do, who are the various beneficiaries of this project and all those things. Because the question which you will be facing in exam will not be related to the controversy directly, but most of the times it is related to the other technical details and other peripheral issues which are linked with the particular controversy. So we'll get into the basics first. So what is this project basically, the Satluj-Yamuna link? It is a 214 kilometer long canal which is proposed to link Satluj and Yamuna river. So you have Satluj river and you have a Yamuna river. Now you are trying to connect these two rivers with the help of a canal, a 214 kilometer canal. And out of this 2014 kilometer, 112 kilometer lies in Punjab and around 92 kilometer lies in Haryana. So this is passing through two states and that is what the controversy is. So we'll look into the controversy also later. So सबसे पहले ये सारी चीज़ें समझने के लिए ना आपका रिवर वाला कॉन्सेप्ट जो है वो क्लियर होना चाहिए कि कौन सी रिवर कहाँ से पास होती है एंड वॉट आर द वेरियस स्टेट्स विच आर बेनिफिटिंग फ्रॉम दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग. तो सतलज डज नॉट ओरिजिनेट इन इंडिया, इट इज़ ओरिजिनेटिंग इन तिब्बत. दिस मैप इज नॉट वेरी एग्जैक्ट बट स्टिल दिस विल गिव यू अ फेयर आइडिया. नाउ दिस इज योर हिमाचल प्रदेश, दिस इज पंजाब एंड नाउ हियर यू हैव हरियाणा, राइट? So Satluj is entering into India in Himachal Pradesh, then it is flowing into Punjab and then finally it is entering into Pakistan and meeting Indus, right? So it is not even coming into Haryana. Ab Haryana ko agar Satluj ka pani chahiye to how will it get it? To iske liye aapko ek canal banana padega. Ab canal abruptly kahin to terminate nahi ho jayega, right? You cannot bring a canal like this. So where will the water flow? So you have to link it to some other river, right? So this is what is proposed. They are trying to make a canal in this particular location, right? So this is what the project envisages to do. Okay, where is it located? Let's zoom into this particular area and try to understand what are the various features available here. So this is your Satluj river which is entering into Punjab. This is Himachal Pradesh, this is Punjab, and this white color line is the boundary between Himachal Pradesh and Punjab. So Satluj is entering here into Punjab and it is flowing in this direction. You have Bhakra and Nangal Dam here, so Govind Sagar Reservoir, and this is the point where just after the river enters into Punjab, they are trying to divert some of the water into this particular canal and then finally it is getting into Yamuna river, right? Okay. And here you have Haryana. So this is where Haryana comes into picture. 92 kilometers of the canal lies in Haryana and they have already finished their side of patch of the canal because they are the main beneficiaries and they are only needing this particular thing, and Punjab is a little reluctant to move ahead with this project. And why was it proposed? Iski kya zarurat aan padi? कि कहाँ से ये सब चीज़ें ओरिजिनेट हुई उसको पहले समझ लेते हैं. 1966 के पहले पंजाब का मैप जो था वो ऐसा नहीं दिखता था. हिमाचल प्रदेश, पंजाब एंड हरियाणा, दिस एंटायर रीजन वॉज पंजाब बिफोर 1966. 1 नवंबर 1966 पंजाब वॉज ट्राइफर्केटेड इनटू थ्री स्टेट्स, पंजाब, हिमाचल प्रदेश एंड हरियाणा. दीज वर द स्टेट्स एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश वॉज अ यूटी एट दैट टाइम विच वॉज मेड अ स्टेट लेटर. तो जब हरियाणा अलग हुआ तो हरियाणा की डिमांड भी उठी कि वी शुड बी गिवन अ शेयर इन द वाटर विच पंजाब इज़ हैविंग सो दैट वी कैन इंश्योर वाटर सिक्योरिटी एंड फूड सिक्योरिटी फॉर फ्यूचर. तो उस तरह से ये सारी डिमांड स्टार्ट हुई 1966 में फॉर शेयरिंग सतलज एंड ब्यास. ब्यास इज़ अ ट्रिब्यूटरी ऑफ सतलज ओनली. सो सतलज एंड ब्यास वाटर बिटवीन पंजाब, हरियाणा एंड राजस्थान. राजस्थान ऑल्सो कम्स इन टू पिक्चर बट इट इज़ अ माइनर बेनिफिशियरी. एंड देन अ ट्राइपार्टाइट एग्रीमेंट वॉज साइन बिटवीन दीज पार्टीज इन 1981. So we are discussing an issue which is very old. Now this is 25 years old issue which we are discussing now. Then what is the progress made till now? Project ka kya current status hai? So land acquisition started in Punjab in 1978 itself and almost 90% of the project is already complete. We are talking about the part which lies in Haryana. Punjab has not done major chunk of the work. देन वॉट इज द इशू नाउ? अचानक से क्या कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी स्टार्ट हो गई? तो नाउ पंजाब इज प्रोटेस्टिंग अगेंस्ट दिस. पंजाब इज टेलिंग कि नहीं भाई, वी डोंट हैव इवन अ सिंगल ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर एक्स्ट्रा सो दैट वी कैन शेयर इट विद हरियाणा. वी आर अ वाटर स्केयर्स स्टेट एंड वी आर नॉट हैविंग एनी एक्स्ट्रा वाटर, वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू शेयर एनीथिंग. देन हु आर द पीपल हु आर फॉर एंड अगेंस्ट एंड वॉट आर देयर आर्ग्यूमेंट्स? वॉट काइंड ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट्स आर दे पुटिंग फॉरवर्ड? so this will help us understand the matter little more clearly. So now Punjab is against the project. They are telling you we don't have a single drop of surplus water. How can we share it with Haryana? And depriving Punjab will affect the nation's food security because we are major agrarian state and top producer of wheat and some other important crops, right? And RAD panel, which was established to divide the water between these two states, is irrelevant now. They are telling that 25 years have passed and you are making all the judgments based on the situations which were prevalent at that time. Now the demography of the state has changed, the population has changed, the cropping pattern has changed, the availability of water has changed, the climate has changed. So many things have changed and still you are relying on an agreement which had taken place 25 years ago. And this last point is very important. They are also telling that Haryana is a non-riparian state. As we saw, the river is not even passing into Haryana. So if two states are sharing a particular river, then we can obviously talk about, you know, how much share these two states will have. But a state which is not even having a single kilometer of that river, and then it is asking for some water. So what is the moral obligation on Punjab? So that is what they are arguing here. Now Haryana is telling that no, the agreement was already in place and now you have unilaterally quashed it. So how can you do that? This is against the spirit of the democracy, the federalism. Now Haryana is also an agrarian state. They are telling that this will also affect the food security of the country. Actually, both these states are beneficiaries of Green Revolution, and during Green Revolution, the cropping pattern has really changed and they have moved to a lot of water intensive crops. That is why both the states are in dire need of water, and they are telling you we will not settle with anything below what RAD panel has awarded us, and they are accusing Punjab of playing politics over water. So this is what the current allegations are against Punjab. Then what is the history of the dispute? 1981 under Indira Gandhi settled this particular issue actually. Then Satluj Yamuna link canal was proposed and Haryana and Punjab both agreed at that time. 2004 something interesting happened. After Punjab assembly passed another Punjab termination of agreement, which unilaterally declared all the earlier agreements null and void. So they said ki purane wale jo bhi agreement hai hum usko nahi mante aur ye canal jo hai wo nahi banegi. Then the matter reached Supreme Court in the same year in 2004, but this court kept the issue pending for 12 years, and now in 2016 suddenly this has again came to the forefront. Matter reached Supreme Court. This is also very interesting because we should understand the technicalities of this. This act was actually passed, it was not passed in the parliament, it was passed in the state legislative assembly, and whenever you pass an act in the Vidhan Sabha, then you have to send it to the governor for ratification. And governor has an option of referring it to the president, and then the president has an option of referring it to the Supreme Court in order to seek consultation on the particular matter. Supreme Court received this matter in 2004 itself, but it did not act immediately on that and it was pending. 2016 Haryana moved Supreme Court and it said ki let's get it clarified soon. Then Supreme Court also entertained the matter, and then 2016 suddenly this came to the forefront. Then revival of the dispute, how this has happened. So Punjab also came to know that okay, now Supreme Court is going to decide on that particular order, and before that let's do something which solves our purpose. So 14th March 2016 they passed a bill, this particular bill, Punjab Satluj Yamuna Link Canal Land Transfer of Property Rights Bill 2016. तो इसकी वजह से वो क्या कर रहे थे इस बिल में, दे वर ट्राइंग टू गिव बैक ऑल द लैंड विच वॉज एक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोजेक्ट. जिन लोगों से वो ज़मीन ली गई थी उनको वो वापस कर रहे थे. तो दिस बिल वॉज पास्ड फॉर दैट. नो हरियाणा अगेन मूव टू सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड इट सेड कि इफ़ द लैंड इज़ अगेन गिवन बैक देन द प्रोजेक्ट कैनॉट बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड, एंड सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज़ नॉट गिवन एन इट्स वर्डिक्ट ऑन दैट. The matter is still subjudiced, then how can you pass such a bill? Then Supreme Court on 18th March 2016, it ordered a status quo on the particular matter. So this is what the controversy is and the current status. Now why is this canal important? It is important because we are talking about two agrarian states, Haryana and Punjab, right? This water is very important for them, and Rajasthan is also a minor beneficiary of that, and it is already a dry state, water scarce state, so this is definitely going to benefit it. And 90% of the work on the Haryana side is already complete with a public expenditure of 700 crore, so it seems logical to finish this project and reap the benefits of that. Then shipping industry will also benefit from this because now you have Satluj, you have यमुना एंड देन यू हैव यू नो गंगा. सो यमुना इज़ मीटिंग गंगा इज एट अलाहाबाद हियर एंड गंगा इज़ गोइंग इन टू योर बे ऑफ बंगाल एंड देन यू हैव सतलज हियर. नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर रिवर विथ यमुना. सो वॉट यू आर बेसिकली डूइंग इज यू आर कनेक्टिंग द ईस्टर्न मोस्ट एंड द वेस्टर्न मोस्ट पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस रिवर चैनल. So this will be good for the riverine transportation. Now since we have started this topic and so we should touch about we should study little bit about Satluj and Yamuna river in detail. So Satluj originates at Rek Rakshasthal in Tibet. This is where it originates, Satluj. Okay, and it passes through Himachal Pradesh and Punjab and then it enters into Pakistan. Then it merges with Chenab to form Panchnad which joins Indus. So you have Chenab and Ravi. Chenab and Ravi meet together and then it is known as Chenab finally. This is Chenab. Chenab and Satluj are meeting at this particular point and then this small patch till it meets Indus. This small patch is known as Panchnad because this contains the water of five rivers. Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. Right? And finally it meets into into Indus which it ends in Arabian Sea. Then some of the important tributaries are Bias and Satluj. Both are Bias and Spiti. Both are right bank tributaries. Then longest it is also the longest river of Punjab. Punjab is basically the name of Punjab comes from the five rivers. The name of five rivers, Panch plus Ab. Ab means water. So it is the land of five rivers. Which are those five rivers? Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. These are the five rivers. And when we say Punjab, we are not talking about Punjab state, we are talking about Punjab region. What is Punjab region? Punjab region is this pre-partition Punjab. So even this part was Punjab, this is Punjab, and Himachal Pradesh was also part of Punjab and Haryana was also part of Punjab before 1966. So this is the region we are talking about when we talk about the land of five rivers. Okay, then some bonus points about Yamuna river also. Yamuna originates in Uttarakhand at Yamunotri Glacier which is located at Bandarpuch Peak in the Himalayas and it merges into Ganga at Triveni Sangam in Allahabad. Triveni, why is it known as Triveni? Because teen nadiyan milti hain, samana jata hai, Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. Saraswati to it is a mythological river or log kehte hain ki underground river hai jo bhi hai. So this is what it is, right? And some important cities on the bank of the river Yamuna: Delhi, Mathura, Agra. Agra ke piche jo ye river wala patch hai, this is Yamuna. And then Itawa, Kalpi and Allahabad. Allahabad is a place where Ganga and Yamuna meet. Then some tributaries, left bank tributaries jo hai uske, wo Hindon, Sharda, Tons. Hindon also passes through Delhi. And right bank tributaries are Chambal and Betwa. So this is how Yamuna looks like. यमुना यहाँ से ओरिजिनेट होती है उत्तराखंड में, यमुनोत्री ग्लेशियर. देन इट कम्स टू दिल्ली. दिल्ली के बाद में यू हैव आगरा हियर. देन चंबल इज़ मीटिंग, दिस इज चंबल. चंबल इज़ मीटिंग यमुना एट इटावा एंड इट मूव्स फॉरवर्ड एंड देन इट मीट्स बेतवा विच इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रिवर एट हमीरपुर. दिस इज हमीरपुर, राइट? सो एंड इट फाइनली meets Ganga in Allahabad. So that's all guys, thanks for listening and please like, comment, subscribe and share if you like this video. And one more thing, if you have any topic in mind then please let us know in the comment section. We will try to take up in the coming lectures. So that's all for today. Thank you. Bye bye.